This is the 36-slot sample concentrator. The nitrogen tank located next to the hood is attached to the sample concentrator by tubing, controlled by this red valve. Make sure that the valve is open, where the handle is parallel to your tubing, before starting gas flow. The sample concentrator itself consists of a grid of needles and a tube rack. The green tape serves as a guide for positioning the rack so that the needles will sit nicely in your tubes when lowered. Load your tubes into the rack. Make sure to position the lids such that they do not overlap other tube slots, otherwise they will interfere with the lowering of the needles. You may slide the tube rack out for loading if that's easier. Open the nitrogen tank completely by turning the knob to the left. You will see the pressure gauge respond when the tank is opened. Next, open the regulator. Note that for the regulator only, righty-tighty does not apply. Turn right to allow more gas to flow and left to restrict gas flow. Never fully left tighten the regulator. This will damage it. Instead, base your decisions off sound. You will hear the gas escaping when the regulator is open. Lower the needles using the knob. Pay attention as the needles approach the tubes. Watch closely and adjust as needed. Position the needles such that they enter the tops of the tubes, leaving space between needle and liquid. Do not touch the needle to the liquid. Lower slowly and watch your tubes. The goal is to achieve a slight dimpling in the liquid, which I have exaggerated for you here, without flinging sample around your tube. As samples dry, you may have to adjust gas flow and needle position to maintain that slight dimpling in the surface of your sample. When things look dry, raise the needles and remove a tube. Take care not to bump the needles as you do so. Check thoroughly that your tube is completely dry. Remaining solvent will interfere with chromatography. Remove all remaining tubes, checking each to make sure no liquid remains. Place your tubes on ice. When you are finished drying, close the nitrogen tank. Remember that to turn off gas flow, turn the regulator to the left. Be gentle and tighten only until you hear gas flow cease. Then turn off the main valve of the nitrogen tank to the right. You will notice that the pressure in the tank remains, and you can vent the remaining gas in the lines to release that pressure by opening the regulator slightly. Remember to return it to its original position by turning gently to the left.